So sa mama, no? Ay,
kita na yan. Yeah, but same. Pugay lang gusto mo test ko
ba? Info, info. Then to teach you some good things about maths.
Virat ko bhej do. Okay, Bharat, please keep your video off.
Ma'am, shall we start? It's 4 o'clock.
Yeah, I think so. It is 4 now. Yeah.
So good evening, everybody, and welcome to this mathematics webinar series on strategies and solutions for boosting mathematics learning. St. Xavier's Institute of Education has been conducting this webinar, and we have a lot of participants joining us to improve the situation of mathematics in schools and colleges and look at mathematics in a different perspective. So to begin this, I would request our principal, Dr. Susamma Samuel, to say a few words.
Thank you, Dr. Vinny. Good evening to all. I think our Father Blaise, our manager, who is present here. So Father Blaise and all participants, those who are present here, and also today's resource person, Dr. Sunita Shah, all are welcome to this program. So I, at the outset, I welcome all participants to this free webinar on strategies and solutions for boosting mathematics learning. The speciality of this program is that it is a free webinar, and also it is conducted by the Mathematics Pedagogy Unit of our college, that is headed by Dr. Vinny Sebastian. You have seen now Dr. Vinny. So she is in charge of the Mathematics Pedagogy Unit and Mathematics Pedagogy students. So that is a very special thing, and definitely it is an appreciate that for the last more than 1 year, so the pedagogy unit, Mathematics Pedagogy Unit, is conducting this free webinar on strategies and solutions for boosting mathematics learning. And the main purpose, I can say that the main purpose of this webinar is to, as the title says, to boost mathematics learning. So in the last 1 year, the sessions, there were different types of learning was taking place. There were like research papers were there. There were other studies also. So the resource persons were sharing their knowledge, and it was a platform to share knowledge, to develop knowledge, and also to create interest in mathematics teaching, as well as to create interest in mathematics learning in students. And we know that the mathematics difficulties, the students have mathematics difficulties, and students also sometimes, most of the times we have seen, they have less interest in mathematics. They have some fear towards mathematics. So all these were different topics we have discussed during these sessions. And definitely this seminar was contributing a lot to mathematics teaching and mathematics learning, or we can say that it was educating the teachers and the students related to mathematics concept. So definitely the Mathematics Pedagogy Unit was doing a good work. Now in today's, I think today's topic is something different. It is empowerment through creative problem solving by Madam Sunita Shah. So when I was looking at the topic, I have seen that it is problem solving plus creative problem solving and empowerment. Like, so there are two, three things are there. Like, so problem solving, we know that problem solving is a skill, which is very important skill for mathematics teaching as well as mathematics learning, or we can say that to solve a problem. So that is a particular skill, or it is a very important skill of scientific thinking, that problem solving skill. So problems, we know that problems are there always. Problems are at home, problems are at work, everywhere there are problems. Like, but how we solve it, that is very important. Like, but in today's we know that we all know that we all are mostly teachers and students and teachers of, like, you know, different courses and all. Like, we know that technology is one of the problems today. So that is also, like, you know, because we encounter the problems very now, and often we encounter that problem. So that solving is also a very important skill. So in mathematics also, problem solving skill, like how to solve a problem, is a very important skill. And I think Madam Sunita is going to speak to us something different, means creatively how to solve the problem. So something one step ahead, and then again she is going ahead with how we will empower through creative problem solving. I think so that part we can leave to Madam Sunita, because we don't know what she is going to tell us and enrich us on this topic. So I think we will listen to Madam, and she is going to definitely enrich us on this topic, how to master this problem solving, and also how to master creative problem solving, and also how to empower students or the teachers through creative problem solving. So we will I welcome this Madam Sunita and all participants to this seminar, free webinar, and also I welcome our Father Blaise and all these all participants to this seminar. Thank you so much, Vinny. All the best for you and your team for taking up this initiative, and all the best.
Thank you, ma'am, for your kind, motivating words. So as I said before, and good evening, Father Blaise, and good evening, Dr. Veena Deshmukh, ma'am. She is on YouTube joining with us. So she's always motivating us for this mathematics webinar. So as I said, that the monthly series on strategies and solutions for boosting mathematics learning is taken up by the mathematics pedagogy unit. And we continue our journey to understand mathematics as a subject and also develop the skills for teaching and share our perspectives on this platform. On this platform, we have people who are interested in the same objective. They come and they share their expertise on this platform. So I thank all the resource persons till now who have shared their expertise on the mathematics webinar series. And we have our student coordinators who are helping us. So for today's webinar, we have Blith, Numel, Nilsima, Olisa, Saloni, Sarang, Susan, and Rachel doing different activities and helping to get this webinar organized for us, and see that we have an enriching experience here in this webinar. We would like to connect to each one of you via email, that is mathslearning@sxi.in. I'll put it up on the chat also, or through the WhatsApp group that you have joined. We would be happy to receive your 1 minute video of any innovation that you find in mathematics. So if you want to share your expertise also in mathematics teaching learning like a resource person, please contact us. And we have this evening Dr. Sunita Jain, a passionate researcher and consultant in mathematics, who will be sharing her views on empowerment through creative problem solving. Ma'am, we really thank you for accepting our invitation, and we look forward to an enriching session with you. Before we start the session, I would like to give few instructions to the participants. Kindly put your videos off so that we can have, there's no bandwidth issues. And please keep your mics off. In case you want to ask a question, you are free to unmute yourself and ask the question. We have the chat facility, so you can put up your questions on the chat. The student coordinators will pick up those questions and present it to the resource person. So without any delay, I would request Nilsima to come forward and introduce our resource person for the day. And when the session is on, we have Susan and Rachel who will be looking after the question answer session and all the activities which are planned for you in the session. As I said in the chat, that there are a number of activities which are planned, and ma'am has really taken a lot of pains to organize these activities. So I request you all to participate in large numbers in these activities for the success of this webinar. Thank you, and over to Nilsima.
Yes, thank you, ma'am. On this eve, I'm privileged to introduce our guest speaker, Ms. Sunita Shah. Ma'am is interested in education research, especially mathematics education. Ma'am has completed her MPhil and PhD in math education. In MPhil, ma'am investigated math's empowering pedagogy, which switches mechanical memorization to pattern exploration and solution investigation that enhances students' critical and creative thinking. Madam's MPhil work investigated origami as a tool in mathematics. Due to the abstractness and high logical demand, children withdraw themselves from mathematics education. But Madam feels that this scenario can be changed by making mathematics education more approachable and interesting to them. According to Ms. Shah, this can be done in many ways, and one of them is by introducing innovative tools in mathematics learning. Today, we are honored to have you, ma'am, and on behalf of our principal, manager, staff, and students of St. Xavier's Institute of Education, I welcome you, ma'am, and we are so eager to listen to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Ms. It's a really beautiful introduction. I'm audible to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
I'm audible. Yes, ma'am. Okay. May I start?
Yes, ma'am.
With the permission of Principal, Father, and Vaiti, I'm starting my presentation. My topic is empowerment through creative problem solving. Now, what is empowerment and the creative problem solving? Everyone might have some perception about it. And what I think for this and what I have done in my research that I'm going to discuss with this in this presentation. Now, for each activity, to write your means, there's a different activities and moves are planned in this workshop. And to write your response, I had given a space in the chat box for the Zoom platform, and the comment space is given for the YouTube participant. Now, this first activity is identify any mathematical term that you associate to your name. You have to identify any mathematical term that you associate to your name. Okay, and for this activity, I have given a link that you can find in the chat box for Zoom platform and in comment space for YouTube participant. Please open it and write which word of mathematics you like to associate, you like to put in your name the way you like. You may write in a prefix or suffix form. I hope everybody is thinking of different mathematical word terms, mathematics terms, words. If it is done, then submit it. Let us see some of the responses. Okay. I think it is visible to everyone. I'm audible.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, I got some of the responses. The responses are visible to you, everyone.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, responses like infinity UT, then parabola Sudha. You can see I'm scrolling down some of the responses. Deepak circle, sequence, sets, only sets. Okay. Vijeta, polygon. That means different mathematical term and your name you have written. Even I'm getting some responses. Okay. Suman Sam. Very nice. I got different nice. In fact, still some they want to, because there is not, it is not limited to only one response. If you want to put more response, you can resubmit the form in case if you want. Okay. Now we have seen some of the responses. Some of you have written using as a prefix. Some of you have written as a using it as a suffix. Some of you have written mixing by mixing it with along with your name, any mathematical term. Now keep these all responses in your, which you can remember, retain in your mind. And with this, we are moving to our next activity, which I have termed as moves, and which are the, how this workshop is flowing, these activities are flowing, the chart of this you can see next. The very first, we'll see all pervasive nature of maths. Next to it, our relation with maths. Next, our construct of maths empowerment, what we think of it. What are the ways of maths empowerment? Then creative problem solving. And our last move is about my lessons plan, my lesson plan and worksheet. Now, let us start with the first move. My dear participant, now think of some incident, process, object, anything where you really don't find maths. You have to think of. And just think, close your eyes and think where you can't find anything, any object or anything, any incident, any event where you really don't find maths, and think. And in chat box, you'll find a link and open that link. Both YouTube participant and Zoom participant will find it. Open it and write at least three responses where you can't find. Hello. YouTube participant, did you get the link I have shared in the comment box there?
Yes, ma'am, they got the link.
Okay. Okay, we'll see some of the responses. I think now these responses are visible to everyone.
Yes.
Okay. Now see some of the responses. Maths is there in everything. Maths is everywhere. No such event. Sanskrit, Hindi, English, photosynthesis, tissue. Now see, in some responses, okay, I got many responses like, okay, math is everywhere. Emotion, math is not in emotion. Math is not in grammar. Okay. Now I want some participant to unmute themselves and explain me how it is not in short, knots, bags. How it is not in video game, emotion. Please, some of you explain me how it is not. The maths is not in this all. Any one of you?
Well, if you talk about fashion designing, mm-hmm. I feel in fashion designing, you require a lot of maths where you need to know the breadth, the length, you know, the size, everything. Okay. It requires maths.
Yeah. Very nice. Okay, you have answered where you find math, at least three objects where you find math. Okay. The question is where you do not find math.
I don't think that there is anything where we do not find math because math is everywhere. At least functional mathematics is required.
Okay, everywhere. Now, I have seen one response like Sanskrit, Hindi, English. Please, any one of you unmute. And I think it is written, it is not in Hindi. Math is not in Hindi, not in English, not in Sanskrit, like not in grammar. I think it is responded in this way. Hello? Any one of you, those day I have answered, I'm not asking to that participant only. Any one of you can answer. Hello? Participants? I'm audible to everyone?
Yes, yes. Actually, even in, hello, can I?
Huh?
Yeah. Actually, even those languages also mathematics being used. So I don't know who has written, but even the Sanskrit, the fonts which you say, the grammar, like wherever you are making everything, every word, we can find the applications of mathematics over there. So being a math person, we will try to find out mathematics in that as well. But okay, as a language, math is not there, but I don't think so it is Correct.
What about emotions? I found one reply this way also, emotions somewhere. Emotions. What about in emotions?
Even in emotion also, the you know, you can say how much emotional you are. Like, okay. You know, like to what extent.
Yeah.
Yeah. Intensity.
Yeah.
Emotions.
Yeah.
Correct.
Presence or absence of whether it is there or not. But whoever answer, whether the math is found there or not found, it is the perceptions person. It is the perception of the person. How we perceive it, it depends on the perception. The person, those they have written, not found in emotion. Like if the person is perceiving in that manner, in that fashion, then one person can think, oh, math is not there. But in actual sense, in a factual sense, if anyone analyzes, then everywhere you can find maths. But why everywhere? My question is, why everywhere there is maths? Why we find everywhere? Any incident, any event, any object, any fact, everywhere we are finding maths. How come it this way? It can't be possible. Why it is happening? Why maths exist everywhere? Please, any one of you.
Ma'am?
Yeah?
Ma'am, because it's a very vast subject. I mean, it's a very vast methodology where indirectly or directly, we always need numbers or, you know, measurements or things related to mathematics. Mm-hmm. I mean, you may not need, for example, derivatives in everyday math, but a basic, like if you talk about even a say bed sheet, then you need size.
Mm-hmm.
Or if you talk about emotions, you need to know, like, you know, how much, even if you talk about how much chemically things are in your brains, to know about the chemical, you need to know about how much.
Yes.
So I guess that is why you always need math.
Yeah, it's really beautiful. Yeah, yes.
Ma'am, can we say that mathematics is the language of universe?
Wonderful. It's a language. Yeah, it's language of universe. But how it becomes language of universe? Why it became language of the universe? Because of what?
Ma'am, good afternoon.
Yeah. Good afternoon to you, dear.
Max is a subject without says about the quantity, whether it is a high amount of quality or low. Without calculation, we can't proceed and we cannot survive. We are happy. How much we are happy? The percentage defines max. How much we are sad? The percentage is decides max. So max is present in happiness. It is present in amount of sadness. So I can say max is a universe and we people are depending upon max.
Yeah. Very nice. Can we say max is rule-based? It is based on formula. It is based on pattern. And since everywhere there is some pattern, some kind of pattern, existence of pattern. If you see this universe, there's an existence of pattern. If we see
it's in nature.
Yeah, it's nature, natural.
Hello.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah.
Somebody saying something.
Max is in the nature, ma'am. Actually, yes. We can see the more we feel lighter, the more we reach the height.
Yeah.
So the more we are the lighter, the more we reach the height.
Yes.
So if our thoughts are in a positive manner, if our thoughts are in positive manner,
yes.
So they become lighter and we can reach to our goal, to our success.
Mm-hmm.
This is what the calculation max teaches us in the nature. Be silent and be patient is max what it teaches for us.
Okay. Yes. Yes. Max is...
And also, ma'am, the formulas that we are using is always like same throughout the like world. Everywhere the formulas or the like addition and all that we use are same. They are not changing like the other subjects.
Hmm. Okay. If I say waterfall, if I say a waterfall, then what mass in that?
Ma'am, height.
Okay, wonderful. Then?
Flow rate of the water.
Yeah, wonderful.
The energy can be calculated by kinetic energy.
Yes.
Force.
Yes, force is there. Even music is there.
Music, sound.
This pressure. Pressure.
Yeah. Yes. They are different. Like we can have different form. Even there are many formulae existing right now. Many formulae are there. And even if you think all, if you observe, these formulas are nothing but the generalization of formula, generalization of the nature. Whatever the observation, whatever we observe, we generalize it. And this generalization is represented in terms of some symbols. These symbols and formulas, this all observational generalization is nothing but the math formula. And if you observe the thing in a different manner, even you can generalize and can put forward some new formula, the new operations in mathematics. And this way maths grows.
Hello. Hello.
Yes. Yes.
Ma'am, can we say that instead of considering mathematics as a subject of formulas, we can say that it is a subject of patterns only?
Yeah, patterns. And yeah, really very good. It's excellent. And the, how the pattern is presented, how the pattern is presented in front of everyone. How the pattern, some pattern is there. How the pattern is represented. If I say sequence or series, then how the sequence and series is represented. If anything, any pattern is there, then that pattern is represented in which manner? Generally, not always, but generally, how it is represented.
Madam, rainbow. The pattern of rainbow from the nature which we see, the different colors of joy, feeling, happiness. Yes. So the seven represents the different feelings of human being.
Wonderful.
So this is related, related to Max, which teaches that seven colors, with your colors, will reflect different flavors of anger, sorrow, and charity and all. So I feel Max is very close to the nature. The only thing is we need to express and we need to look out the nature and analyze it.
Yeah, wonderful. Now, just before to this activity, this move, you have replied about your name. Like one activity was there. It is visible to everyone.
Yes, yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now see, in this, just see the responses. Do you feel it is your responses are very restricted and conditioned to the textbook and what we learned till now? It is not, since maths, nature is maths, then we could have had different types of name, like beautiful, Babita. Even beauty is maths. Any word you can pick and can write your name. It can be?
Yes,
we can, but generally, you know, what we feel that these terms reflects mathematics only.
Why we are restricted to this term only? Why we can't see the nature as an entire mass? Why it is happening? Yeah, anyone please?
Ma'am, maybe because that's how our psychology has been trained until now. When we say maths, we have been trained to think of formulas, shapes, and such. We have never been exposed to the fact only that maths is everywhere. Maybe that is why when we were set to connect our names to something related to maths, the fact that everywhere it is connected did not come to our minds in the first place. Maybe that is why.
Okay. Yeah. Because of that. Then as a teacher, what's our duty then? Then as a teacher...
Actually, what we people are being taught is mathematics is all about algebra, arithmetic. So that is the reason we are confined. We have confined ourselves to these terms only.
Okay. Then how to break this routine or this train? How to break?
Definitely, we have to go beyond the curriculum, exactly what we can say.
Okay. This is really wonderful. Now, after
exactly
that means...
If we, ma'am, sorry to interrupt. One more thing I would like to say. That when we talk to our students, generally, they people also are have, means if I'll ask the same question to my students, they'll be reflecting the same thing. And that is the reason generally students say that they won't find mathematics around themselves. So what I sometimes I just try to ask students in every topic, just try to see the things around you, where you can find this particular topic. So, but you know, sometimes the curriculum restrict us to find the things within the books only. That is the major issue.
Okay. Now we'll keep this issue with us. Okay. Yeah. Somebody is saying something.
Yes, ma'am. Also, one example right in front of us is that if you would have asked us a maths question in the starting only, many of us would have got bored or not replied in the first place. But like suppose it was an equation or some algebra where you have to find x, but now with these questions which are partly related to maths and partly related to other aspects which have maths, that is why we got more interested in learning about what this, you know, what this lecture has in store. So that's one example of teaching.
Really nice. Means you want to say that we have to blend like constraint textbook maths along with the practical daily life maths. You want to say this?
Yes, ma'am. Yeah.
Very nice. Now we'll move to next move. Okay. Now for this, I want to request everyone to close your eyes. Please, every one of you, close your eyes and do reverse counting from 20 to 1. Close your eyes, everyone. Now countdown starts. 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Don't open your eyes. Now think of your childhood memories related to maths. Think of your school days, college days memory related to maths. Think the pleasures which you had with maths. Think the pain which you had because of maths. Think of if you ever copied maths homework. Think if you helped anybody to copy your maths handbook. Think of your maths learning, how you learned. Think of your maths teacher. Think how you learned maths. Reflect it. Observe it. See it and hold. Be calm. And now think whether there's some change happened after your maturity? Think of that. Now, slowly, everyone, open your eyes and you'll find a link, two links in your chat box and comment box. And comment box, I'll put now. Rachel, if it is possible for you, put it.
Yes, ma'am, I have posted both the links.
Okay. And each one of you, please feel that your whatever feeling, real feeling, whatever you felt with maths, feel that in that form. Okay. I'm audible to everyone?
Yes, ma'am, you are.
Okay. Yes. Have you seen the responses? Yeah. The responses which I got was a mixed kind, but mostly it is positive towards maths. Mostly it was positive towards maths. That means, can we say during school time, some of the students, they are not have voice to share their idea, their thought to the teachers. They are not very comfortable to answer. And we can say the students, they are not so power. They don't feel so powerful, confident enough to share, to talk on maths. And that's why what I feel the maths, the student must be mathematically empowered or maths empowered. And
Dr. Sunita, the screen is not visible. So is it possible to stop sharing and reshare?
It is visible now?
Yes, yes.
Okay. Okay. Now, what is maths empowerment according to you? Yeah, what is maths empowerment according to you? Anyone, please?
Ma'am, can I?
Yeah.
Yes. Ma'am, it means that even if the student makes mistake in the early age and in any time of their life, so we should empower by saying that it is okay to make mistake, but ultimately after learning, you will conclude and you will find solution.
Okay, fine. Any other, in fact, you might have got some link in the box. And you can write about, because I can't have much time to listen everyone's, and everyone can put their thought on the maths empowerment. And when I started doing my research on maths empowerment, initially what happened, I was BEd teacher educator, and I found some of my students, they are maths teacher, but still they are scared and very scared of maths. And this was really very disturbing to me. And then I thought there should be something to be done to empower student in mathematics so that they don't have any fear. And with this thought, I took up this research. And when I started my research, and many people, they asked me on what you are doing your research, I said maths empowerment. And it is very new for everyone. And many, while collecting my data, many, they did not respond to it also, because this is very new term. And I explored a lot about it, and I found very limited literature on it, maths empowerment. And that's why I did a qualitative study on the maths empowerment, what exactly people think, or school teachers, they are thinking, college teachers, they are thinking on the maths empowerment, what exactly the maths empowerment is. And prior to that, I want few of you just say about what is one responded about it nicely. Any other view regarding maths empowerment? What is maths empowerment?
Every time we get fail, for example, in finding the solutions of an equation x equals to 1, 2, 3. So for every time it teaches the trial and error method. With trial and error method in the maths, we learn how to reach the success. Okay. Every failure teaches us the lesson, and it makes us to get closer to the success. So this is what empowerment of maths I feel about.
Okay, nice. Now we'll see some of the literature reviews, what they say. Initially, the maths empowerment, the term, it is coined by the Ernest in 2002. And he spoke about the three domains of maths empowerment, that is social, mathematical, and epistemological. Then Hesse in 2008, he spoke about maths empowerment, and he spoke regarding two levels of the maths empowerment, at the personal level and at the social level. And then on Ortiz, he in 2010, he gave 6 dimensions of maths empowerment. That means maths empowerment has these 6 constructs. Now let us see what is social, mathematical, and epistemological mean. Now social empowerment means the in social scenario, utility of maths. In your life, in your workplace, you are utilizing maths. And when you are very comfortable using in maths, using maths in social platform, then socially maths empowered. Mathematically, maths empowerment, that means doing mathematics. While doing mathematics, mathematical skill, mathematical thinking, all the gaining of this, all things like mathematical empowerment. Epistemological empowerment means a sense of like testing whatever maths you are doing, questioning that, validating the knowledge, approving it. Right? This is internal motivation. Once creates the maths, once the person gets such kind of ability, then as per Ernest, he is epistemological empowered. That these all domains are given by Ernest. Now, Hesse also has same thing, but he identified 2 levels, at the postal level and the social level. That means we are utilizing maths for enhancing our personality and identity, and other the social level, that means we are using mathematics for better life and for better connection, for better environment, economy, and this all. Ernst Otis, in 2010, he identified the 6 domains, that is critical thinking, logical thinking, creative thinking, concern and empathy. That means the person who empowered math, they are concerned about the people and they have empathy. He identified this communication skill. They are using mathematical communication skill and metacognition. Now, when I did research, I did qualitative research and I collected the teacher's perception, college teacher, postgraduate teachers, school teacher, their perception regarding mass empowerment. And then after qualitative analysis, I found mass empowerment, it is nothing but strengthening of mathematical capability and development of entities. Now, development of entities means the learner development, even teachers development, and teaching learning process, the learning process development, and strengthening mathematical capabilities. It has the 4 parts, that is cognitive ability, mathematical skill, affective capabilities, and mathematical language. Under cognitive, you can see knowledge, understanding, application, analysis, and thinking. And mathematical, the problem solving, applying, mastering, computation, and affective capabilities like interest in maths, lowering the anxiety regarding maths, very confident in doing maths, reading, learning maths, and mathematical language, that means acquaint with the symbols, formulae, like this. And also, I also analyzed about the empowered students' characteristics. Now I call it with the qualitative analysis, I found the 3 characteristic under 3 category: cognitive characteristic, affective characteristic, and skill. Under cognitive, I found these all. You can see. Just have a look of this. These are all the characteristics I found of maths empowerment, empowered student as per the teachers. Now, creative problem solving. Okay. Now, what are the ways? Just now, you have seen what is maths empowerment, what are the characteristics of maths empowerment, and you have seen your relation with maths, you have seen all pervasive nature of mathematics. Now, I have a question, how to empower students? What are the ways, how you can empower, which are the ways where you can empower your student mathematically or maths empowerment? Yeah, anyone, please. Hello. Hello. Anyone?
Hello. Yes, ma'am. So one of the way could be wherein in a classroom, you give a student a very positive environment where they can express themselves.
Okay.
And a situation, or maybe an example would be like you give them a situation that is very relevant to real life, and you give them the freedom to you could ask them ki in this situation how do you solve it using math, but you give them the freedom to think creatively and answer, and you, there is no right and wrong there.
Okay, so excellent. That means you have answered like many ways, like situation based learning. You spoke regarding situation based learning, and then you spoke regarding like real life problem, like then problem based learning. That means these are the situation based learning, problem based learning, then creative learning, creative problem learning. These are the different ways via you can empower your student, and while empowering, you must not stress the student. You must give the freedom. Very nicely answered. Now we'll move to next move. Look, creative problem solving. What is creative problem solving? Problem solving, any problem when you analyze, you solve it, it comes problem solving. But when it is creative problem solving, anything new, when any new solution you produce, any kind of new solution, the solution may be new to you, but it is not new for anyone, but it may be new to you. Creative problem solving. Now you can have look of different definitions of creative problem solving. Now, there's one activity for you, and the link is given to you in chat box and comment box. Please open the link. The same question you'll find in the link. And if you want to answer both, you can. If you want to answer any one activity, if you want to do, you can do any one activity. If you want to do this activity in group, then 2 to 3 people on phone, you can discuss and write your answer. Any way you can do it. Yes, we can see very nice responses are given, samosa and sandwich. You can write the mathematics along with it, like pen and rubber, the similarity means what is the base for the similarity. It's very nice, pen and rubber. In many way it is similar. In what is the base for the similarity? Both long object, that means you are speaking on the dimensions. Very nice. Yeah. Okay, you have seen the responses? Yeah, everyone, you have seen some of the responses. What you can say such type of question? Any comment? Hello?
Ma'am, they are open-ended questions.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's open-ended question. But to answer this question, the concept clarity related to maths or on maths supposed to be there? Or anyone can answer anyhow?
Ma'am, even if someone is not familiar with maths, can answer these questions.
Okay. Okay. Then can we use such questions in our mathematics question paper, in maths question paper?
Yes, sure, ma'am. We can use it because actually we have to make sure that the students must understand that whatever they are doing is actually indirectly they are using mathematics.
Mm-hmm.
And we have to show them, we are as the facilitator, we have to only show them there is a math in their daily life. Actually, it is not a separate subject or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
And when we are transferring their learning into a unknown situation, then their innovation is coming.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, we have to train them in such a way that too, they are capable to transfer in a different situation. Actually, they are doing it, but we have to train them how to think like that. That is the only thing we can create the problem solving skills and all.
Yeah, very nice. Can we have such questions in our annual examination? Can we think of?
Hello.
Huh?
Yes, ma'am. So my answer would be yes. Of course, maybe authorities would not allow, but then we could have a justification to this as well. So when we are teaching, what is a quadrilateral? Hmm. Quadrilateral has four something with four sides.
Mm-hmm.
So here it is a similarity of two objects.
Mm-hmm.
Correct. So we could we are never using this approach mm-hmm. to teach something to a student.
Mm-hmm.
So
mm-hmm.
wherein here now when we are asking a student about similarity in such a unique way,
mm-hmm.
and then if we explain to them, yes, so these two objects are similar, so both are not squares but both have four sides.
Mm-hmm.
So it could be a quadrilateral because it is similar.
Mm-hmm.
So this could be linked to some concept and we could ask it in this way. Yeah. It's not necessarily that it has to be, you know, ekdam related to math and it has to have a lot of mathematical look or format. We could ask such questions and make it more interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Which and as and side by side simultaneously, it can be connected to maths as well.
Okay, not all, but few. We can try out one or two questions in our unit test, in our annual examination. You are the teacher. You are the future teacher, and you can do it. Your committee members can think on it and can. It can be implemented. And if we use such open-ended question in our, because everything depends on the evaluation system, how the things are get evaluated. If everything is like a close-ended question, based on the close-ended question, then there's no scope for such empowerment or creative problem solving, students thinking, mathematical thinking, everything will get blocked. And now we have to give hand and we have to implement such new thing in our evaluation system so that student can feel empowered and they can say what they think on maths. And in this way, they may think of some different dimensions of maths which we are not aware of till now. Now, creative problem solving. Many people may think creativity means something discovering, inventing something very great, but it is not. A creativity may be of mini creativity, little creativity, pro creativity, and big creativity. The mini means which is giving satisfaction to me. I made a drawing which will give satisfaction to me, and I feel good, but it may not help anyone. That is very small creativity. When a student, they draw the right answer mathematics in different, put like boxes, sometimes they decorate. We need to like, we can encourage them. At the same time, we can encourage them in mathematical thinking. Little C, that means a bigger group, useful to a bigger group. Pro C, which is useful to more larger group. And big C, it is useful to everybody. Such thing, like you can see the creativity level, mini C, little C, pro C, and big C. Now my lesson plan I have developed based on the creative problem solving model. There are different models of creative problem solving. You can see the model steps here. This is Osborne Parnes creative problem solving model. It has 6 steps. Initially, I started with this problem-solving model. Then later on, I switched to creative problem-solving learner's model, which is more advanced model, and you can find more detail on the link which I've given in the reference. Now, it has 4 broader steps, which is divided into the sub-step. The very first step is clarify. Anything when you want to do creative problem solving, the very first is clarify, then idea, then develop and implement. And based on these steps, I have developed my lesson plan and I implemented those lessons on each standard student. And I found really that is effective in students' empowerment. My maths empowerment dimensions I have taken achievement, maths creativity, maths metacognition, maths utility, and maths anxiety. And I have given maths creative problem solving instruction, which is used for students' maths empowerment, and the dimensions are this. And I found in all dimensions, the maths creative problem solving was effective. Based on that, I concluded that it enhances students' cognitive capability, enhances maths achievement, enhances maths metacognition, enhanced mathematics skill, enhanced maths utility. And this way I concluded the students are maths empowered. Now I'm sharing my one sample lesson plan and worksheet with you all. You can have a look of that. as well as you can see, you can go through the worksheet. I have given the link for worksheet and lesson plan. Open the link for worksheet. You'll find a problem, and there's a lot many constraint on me. That means I have to complete my lesson within the school timing, like 35. Sometimes the lesson time period was 35 and sometimes it was of 30 minutes only. If I get the recess, before recess period, then it is of 35 minutes. And after recess period, then it is of 30 minutes. And with all the constraint, when I utilize this worksheet in the class of around 70 students, the class strength 65 to 70 student class strength was there. And within the time constraint of 35 minutes, and I found it is successful. Have you going through the worksheet? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Please solve the worksheet.
Ma'am, should I share the link of the lesson plan also?
Both.
Okay.
Dr. Sunita, can I ask you some questions on the worksheet?
Okay.
The first one is that the objects are given to you. So what is common? So you write what is common. Then find the data given to you.
Yeah.
So what is it like you are asking for?
The first, if you see the worksheet, I'll open the worksheet. Wait a minute.
Should I share the worksheet?
I think it is visible to everyone.
Yes.
Visible?
Yes. So what is common? Yeah, find the data given to you, that is the objects.
The very first, what you see here, it is a task. It is a task. Okay. Now this task is given to the child, to the student. And based on this task, the steps will follow the creative problem solving learner's model steps we are following here. Very first step is to find what is given to you. Now, I'm not saying anything to the student. Now, this worksheet is given to you. This is your task. What is common in this object and how can you represent this commonness mathematically? This is a task. Now, student, they have to think this all object. If it is in real, we can give this object in real to them and ask them to find the data, means what is given in this. Then what student they'll think, what they'll write. They may write anything. You may come across different and each student they are solving sometimes, and I have given them freedom to do in group or individually, both way. And the student they have given like different. Now, if you do it now, then you can feel how it is going about. And your query, ma'am, it is not two time the question. First is the task. This is the task given, and this one is the steps, the actual worksheet solving steps. Find the data given to you. The student, my expectation, they'll find and they'll write. I'm not saying, but they may write anything. They may write color, which is not related to me. But based on that, how the child is solving and towards, and for everybody, because we are constrained with our syllabus also. We have to complete the portion, and that's why there's a last towards the end. If you see my lesson plan, you will find the summarization step is there. And here, what are the things you have learned, found, generated? And this worksheet, when I'll do my lesson, if you see my lesson plan, I've given of different lesson, and the worksheet of, because two different thing you'll get, that's why I've given. You can go through the work lesson, and you see, if you, anybody solved this, I'll see it here. Okay, cylinder. But this child, if the child is not aware of cylinder, they may write anything. Because for me, they have not written cylinder. For them, the cylinder, the concept was not there. They have written circle, circle, and circle. Matlab, this kind of response I have got. And in between, since the concept is very new, and the observation maybe because it is not utilized, such technique has not utilized, because of that they have restricted observation. And at that time it required me, because I used to take round and read there, then I used to probe, and my probing was like not to the group. I used to come in front and probe. Okay, circle, that means only one circle, like, or many circle, like I used to probe, and after probing, I seen that they used to write more answer in the column, and the probing was required for me. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, in the lesson question, plan, it is very clear when you go through the lesson plan, then it's very clear.
Uh-huh. Okay. And since it is very new to the student, initially they will not do. This is my experience. Initially, they learn, they understand the thing. It is very new to them. And we have to probe. And later you will find, if you apply more of this, then later you will find they'll come with different idea, and it is very difficult for you to control and to test their creativeness, their ideas, because many a time the answer what they gave me to accept, because there's one step, acceptance and rejection, like to accept the idea and reject the idea. It was even difficult for me how to reject, on what basis, because rejection is when we reject, it may be the what the child is saying, it may be true in different kind of mathematics, and to know every type of maths and to test and evaluate, it is really very challenging. Once you use this kind of lesson plan, then you have to like have vast reading on the concept and the thing and different type of mathematics, because the student, because everyone has different perception and way of observation. What we see, like, you know, six blind men and elephant story. Each person, they perceive in a different manner. The same thing I perceive, I think, I plan, but the student, they think, they come up with different idea. It happens. And at that time, immediately to evaluate and comment, and students' expectation is like to comment something on it. Then they feel satisfied. And really, it is very challenging. This I say. Hello.
Yes,
yes. If you have any question, queries, suggestion, or opinion, then there's a link you can share. If you want, you can share your questions, suggestions, queries. And if it is possible for me, I'll try to improvise based on that. Or if any query or question, then I'll try to answer from my side. And these all are the my reference. These all not all my references for research, but for the creative problem solving learners mat model, honest maths empowerment concept. For those, these are the references, and really I'm thankful to St. Javis College, Father, Principal Ma'am, Winnie Ma'am, and the entire committee to give this chance to me. And if any question and query, please ask.
Participants, if you all have any questions, you can unmute yourself and ask, ma'am. Yeah, I think there are no questions, Sunita ma'am. So thank you very much for your very enlightening session on empowering through creative problem solving. And I really want to tell you that you have taken a different topic, and definitely the students will be able to be more involved in maths if there is a lot of creativity in mathematics teaching. And you have really shown us how to infuse that creativity even in mathematics. So thank you very much. And now we move to the next section of the webinar. We have Susan here, who will be providing you a review of the topic on digital learning and mathematics phobia. We have reviewed three studies, and Susan will be presenting some thoughts on the topic on digital learning and mathematics phobia. So over to Susan.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you. Is my screen visible?
Yes.
Okay, let's start. We have researched the topic of web-based learning and its effect on mathematics phobia. Studies have found that online teaching learning has reduced maths phobia in students. Let's review some of this research. The paper titled Causes and Solutions of Mathematics Phobia Among Secondary Students, published in 2016, revealed, among other factors, process techniques such as teachers' method of teaching, use of abusive words, giving too many assignments, lack of reading materials, non-conducive learning environment, non-application of potent instructional materials, and interpersonal factors like teacher-student relationship, inability to solve math problems, poor math backgrounds of students and teachers, as well as the abstract nature of mathematics as causes of mathematics phobia among students. It states that teachers' perceived solutions to math phobia among students are good teacher-student relationship, use of student-centered or innovative approach of teaching, counseling, positive attitude towards maths, improved maths curriculum, breaking down topics into units, and applications of ICT in teaching maths. Other studies by Kaushik Das titled Digital Technologies in Math Education at the COVID-19 Lockdown Situation in India and Integrating E-Learning and Technology in Math Education, both published in 2021, states that digital learning in math allows students to try and study in the comfort of their homes. They obtain front row seats in math's virtual classroom study. They also benefit considerably due to the innovative teaching strategies and teaching math using social media through the internet. Their findings include infrastructure with different collaborating components, both human and digital, create affordances in math education. Math work can be shared for the purposes of comparison, correlation, expansion, extension, or accumulation of ideas. Mobile technology, personal learning environments, digital learning objects and different antiquities are stretching the classroom, transforming the classroom to the extent that it can hardly be recognized as such. Digital technology is deconstructing the notion of classroom. Now, these findings are not limited just to school students. In a study titled Effects of Web-Based Instruction on Math Anxiety, the Sense of Mastery and Global Self-Esteem, they have defined math anxiety as the feeling of anxiety, dread, nervousness, or associated bodily symptoms related to doing math. And their study says that using WBI techniques, that is web-based interaction techniques, reduce class levels of math anxiety. And participation in online student discussion forums also increase students' self-esteem. Their findings suggest that supplementing the conventional course instruction with WBI methods is a promising new approach for statistics students and instructors. And in addition, while responses suggested that students have differed opinions about web-based technologies and how they should be used, a common theme was that technology should complement traditional course instead of replace them. Now, all of this is summarized in the article by Sachin Gulati in his article titled, 9 Ways E-Learning Math Can Do Away with Any Math Phobia and Make You an Expert, where he basically says that when teachers use technology strategically, they can provide greater access to mathematics for all students. Now, this can be done by supplementing the traditional textbook to use video courses. Online tests can also help students rectify set improvement goals. Interactive videos and audiovisual can help make math less abstract. They can absorb math at their own pace, get better time management and direct access to the teachers. And with the help of content-specific technologies, such as computer algebra system, dynamic geometry environments, interactive applets, handheld computation, data collection, analysis devices can also help with the teaching of maths. In all, replacing a traditional classroom with web-based instruction is not the goal. And let's not forget about the online mode once we get back to our traditional classrooms. The aim should be expanding the boundaries of our brick and mortar classrooms to integrate these essential web-based instructions, all with the objective of demoting math phobia in students. Thank you.
Thank you, Susan. Very well presented. And now we come to the end of this webinar. I would request our manager, Father Blaise, if he would like to say a few words before we close the webinar. Father Blaise.
Yes.
Father, you would like to say a few words before we close the webinar?
Okay, I'll say a few words, not coming from a mathematician as such. My field has been very different, but I like the title of this webinar of today. What is that? Empowerment to Creative Problem Solving. Is that it? That is the title, I suppose. Mathematics problem solving. I see you have referred to the fear and phobia that has been connected with mathematics. Somehow or the other, it has been made to sound and look difficult for ordinary students. And it is considered as the field for highly intelligent students and also related with science. So those who are going in for science will see that they need to do mathematics well, whereas it is not so directly connected with the other fields of education like language, history, social sciences. So we have been saying here that it is mathematics is part of every field of life, which is true. And yet at the same time, it has been made so highly abstract that it has distanced itself from the ordinary life of students. And I am saying from my own experience, it is like I have been now for, I am from the city and I am now in the city for quite some time, but I have spent 34 years out in the rural areas. And the thinking is that science and mathematics are fields of study for urban students and not for rural students. And therefore there is this big divide in the sense that, well, those who are considered to be very intelligent are people who are experts in maths and science. And rural students are not able to become such experts, or not much use is made in their field of life, which is connected very much with the land, with agriculture. And yet I know that they do use mathematics, but they do not perhaps use it in the way that we are used to using it in urban setup. So what are we going to do to make mathematics and science also as something that creates curiosity, interest in rural students also? Many years ago, while I was out in the rural areas, we together with Tata Institute of Fundamental Research in Bombay conducted what is called the People's Science Movement. People's Science Movement out in the rural areas there in northern Maharashtra, in Dhule district. And there were people from this field of mathematics who came, and science, who came and tried to make science and mathematics something familiar to the people in the rural areas. Mathematics has to become a people's movement so that they see that it is something that is part of their own life and not something that is for the elite, for people who are highly intelligent. That's what it has been made to look like. And I think Dr. Sunita Shah has tried to give us examples in which the normal thinking of students is involved, the normal thinking. There is one other aspect which I think which we should bring into the field of mathematics, and it has not been clearly referred to, but I think it is there in the way the things were presented and the way our students participated. And that is mathematics, not only creative thinking, critical thinking, and mathematics has to become joyful and happy. It should be something which students enjoy doing, enjoy being part of, like they are part of many other games. So it should be something that makes students happy, happy, involved, creates joy in them, enthusiasm to be part of it, to make mathematics part of their lives. I think that is the role of our teachers of tomorrow, because it is the teachers who will make mathematics a game for our students, a game connected with their lives, connected and related to their lives, their occupations. I think that is what we teachers need to do with mathematics and maybe with all other subjects, with science itself, something that becomes creative because you enjoy it. It's like the statement of Archimedes, no? Eureka, I discovered something. I found something. I'm so happy about it. I'm so excited about it. That is what I think students' experience should be. Emotionally, it should raise them up and make them feel that it's a great field to be in. That's what I hope we will get through all these webinars connected with mathematics, which our principal and Dr. Vinny have taken so much trouble to organize all through the year, so many webinars. But we should become really creative and enjoy. That is what is part of empowerment. Empowerment should be something that we relish, we enjoy, we are happy about. It raises our spirits. That, I think, is something that we need to take away with us from a session or webinar like that, like this that we have had of today. Thank you very all. Thank you very much for giving me a share in this joy of this webinar today. Thank you, Vinny. Thank you, Dr. Sunita Shah, and thank you all, everyone, and our principal, Dr. Sushama Samuel.
Thank you, Father, for your enlightening words. Now I request Saran to propose the vote of thanks, after which Rachel can come and give some instructions. Saran?
Am I audible, ma'am?
Yes.
You are visible also.
Yes, Father, yes. Okay. So, good evening to one and all. It gives me an immense pleasure to propose a vote of thanks on behalf of SXI to all the dignitaries present here. Today, we were able to reflect upon many things, which includes empowerment through creative problem solving, which will help us incorporate learning of evolution and teaching in mathematics. A special thanks to our resource person, Dr. Sunita Shah, who shared her precious tactics on how we can boost our competencies through critical learning. Thank you so much, ma'am. Your expertise tactics for sure will boost mathematical learning in all numerous ways for all the teacher trainings here. Also, ma'am, you have inspired us by making us look maths in everyday life. Then you also explained us the three domains of maths, then the 4C model of creativity. And ma'am, your lesson plans and worksheet were really interesting, ma'am. Also, we would like to inculcate all these with the help of the activities or mode you have taught. Thank you once again for giving us all your precious time and sharing your vast knowledge with us, ma'am. Also, I would like to thank our manager, Father Blaise D'Souza, for sharing his ideas, and our principal, Dr. Sushama Samuel, for her inspiring insights. Genuine thanks to our staff coordinator, Dr. Winnie Sebastian, for giving me this opportunity and for all the countless help and coordination to make this event a success. Also, the session wouldn't be successful without our formation team, who are Blith, Neumel, Alisa, Susan, Saloni, Rachel, and Nilsima, who are all working from behind the curtains and making this webinar flourishing. At last, I would like to appreciate all the participants for being active and engaging during this session and being such a genuine support. Without you, this session wouldn't feel like participants. Looking forward to seeing you all again. Thank you so much.
Over to Rachel and Saloni.
Yes, ma'am.
Instructions.
Yes, ma'am. So a gentle reminder to all the participants present here. A link for the feedback form will be sent in the chat box of the Zoom meeting and in the YouTube chat now. Kindly fill it to get the e-certificate. Also, please note that we are keeping the form open till 7:30 p.m. So all the participants are requested to fill the feedback form before 7:30 p.m. While filling the form, make sure that you enter your correct email address or the certificate will not be delivered to you. And also enter your name correctly because no changes would be done later. If you don't receive your certificate, please wait for 30 minutes and do check your spam folder. After 30 minutes, if you're still unable to get the certificates, then kindly contact any of the students' coordinator regarding the issue.
Okay, thank you, Rachel, and thank you all the participants for attending the webinar. And also, we have in the next webinar, we are going to present the results of our research, which we have conducted on digital learning and mathematics phobia. So do stay tuned for the next webinar next month. See you all, and good evening, and have a happy weekend. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you all. Thanks.
Thank you all.
Thank you, sir, Dr. Sunita. Bye.
Okay, I'm leaving the meeting.
Yes, yes, Father. Bye. Bye.
Bye, Father.
Bye, bye.
Where is the feedback link, Rachel? You have put it here.
Yes, it is there in the chat box.
Yes, ma'am, it's there in the chat box.
So I'll just copy.
Ma'am, they are very eager to feel on YouTube.
Yeah, yeah, that's what I'm just seeing.
Yes, ma'am.
Saran, just check now if it's come on YouTube. I'm just putting it. Come.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am, it is come. It is working.
So I can end the meeting, no, now, so they can fill it.
Yes, ma'am, sure.
Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, welcome. Thank you, everybody. Bye.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.